My guest today is the frontman, singer, bassist, main songwriter for one of the great prog bands out today, Riverside, who are out with a brand new instrumental album called Eye of the Soundscape. I'm pleased to welcome back Mariusz Duda.
Hello, Roy.
Nice to have you back to talk. We talked a few years ago before the Love, Fear, and Time Machine album. Lots and lots of things have happened with you guys, some good, some very, very bad. Let's talk a little bit about, you got the new album coming out, Eye of the Soundscape, October 21st. It's an instrumental record, very electronic, ambient type stuff. You know, what was the decision to make the album or put the music together? Some of it was already made, right? So what was the decision to put this out?
To prove, maybe not to prove, but to show that Riverside is a band who can play that kind of music too, and just to show it to the wider audience, because this music was mostly for diehard fans who bought our special versions in the past. And they didn't, and the new people maybe knew, or some people who know us only from streaming services don't even realize that we can play that kind of music. And that kind of music was always the part of our DNA and the part of our regular albums. I think that releasing that kind of album with pure instrumental ambient music shows that you can take a look at, maybe not shows, but it forces you to take a look on Riverside's music from the wider and more distant perspective. And, in your eyes, Riverside will become a totally different band. I always wanted to have that kind of band. And I always wanted to play in the band that can release albums with different moods, because it could show what the band is naturally, truly. And Riverside for me is a band who can play different type of music, but in one genre, if I can say that.
Yeah, yeah.
So when you take a look at Eye of the Soundscape, you can hear that this is the Riverside. Lots of things, lots of structures are the same, but we have different clothes only, you know. And for me, this is really important release in our career, because it defines our music much more than everything we've done so far.
Yeah, you know, I was reading some early reviews and from people that I know that are Riverside fans and blogs and things, and people really seem to like it, even though it's that different kind. It's not rock. It's not that sort of progressive, you know, metal type stuff that you guys have done. Why do you think the fans really embrace it? I mean, it's not common for a band that is considered sort of prog, I guess, to do something completely different and for people to like it as much. It's, you know, it's a very tough fan base sometimes.
True, but our fans, you know, they know us, right? And they are our fans because they know that we are not strict a progressive metal or progressive rock band, but we experiment with that kind of stuff, and our influences are exactly like this. I think this album, it's maybe not for our diehard fans, it's for other people that they don't even realize that we can play that kind of music, as I said before. So diehard fans support us with this because they are happy that someone else can finally realize that Riverside is a different band than Dream Theater.
Right.
You know, and this is just like, as I said, and I'm just joking, that this is like sledgehammer message for many people, because this is their regular album now, and you don't have any choice. You need to listen to this. You know, when it comes to bonus discs, bonus CDs, so it's like, I don't want to listen to that. You know,
right, that happens.
This album is on Spotify? No, it's not. Okay, so it's not so important. Now it will be on Spotify, so you will have to listen all this stuff, unfortunately. And get bored. But no, seriously, it's just, you know, I'm on this level, in this position, after sixth album, it's also the right to do everything you want to. So we've got this, you know, we wanted, in 2016, we wanted to release our first 5+1 edition of one of our albums, and we wanted to release the pure instrumental album. Why the hell not?
Yeah,
so,
absolutely.
So we simply didn't done this, and I think this is the most progressive thing that we've done so far. I'm not talking about music, but the fact and the bravery that we did that.
That's right. That's right. That's funny, because a lot of times, you know, the progressive fan likes things to be always the same, but that goes against the word progressive if you really
exactly.
think about it. Of course, you know, there was the passing of Pieter and the horribleness that happened with that. You guys recently announced you're going to continue as a three-piece in a beautiful statement that you guys put out. You know, how was that decision made ultimately, and how close were you to calling quits for the band?
You know, after Piotr's death, I was considering if it's the time for me to close the band and start a solo career. Maybe, you know, this is the signal for me that I should focus more on Lunatic Soul. Maybe this is a signal that I should, that this is the end of the story. And we will not have this sound without Piotr. So we should definitely close this. But later I realized that this is such a huge legacy, such a beautiful moments. And if I just simply close this subject, you know, the memory of Piotr will disappear, because people have amnesia this year. Now everyone remember, but you will see what will happen within the next years. People will forget about it, you know, and people will forget about Riverside. I'm not talking about diehard fans. They will be with us, you know, till the very over, right, until the very end. But I'm talking about, you know, in general. But later I realized, no, we need to continue that. And if we continue that, definitely as a trio, because we've been like a family. And it would be so inappropriate to create the casting for a new guitar player and go on a tour and earn money. No, we just said, first, we will cancel all our shows till the end of the year. We will have the time for, you know, just slowing down. Maybe that was a mark from above. I don't know. Someone wanted to us to slow down and just rethink something. And later we said, if we will do something just only as a trio. You know, from the composer point of view, nothing would change. I will be the captain of this ship still. I think I can carry on. I was the main composer in the past. I will be, you know, in the future, unless something will change. But for the next album, for the very next album, I feel strength inside of me, and I know that I can carry on, and I know that I've got something interesting to say still, beside of the thing that I do in my solo project. And I still believe that it can be a band. Anyway, I can take care of the guitar. Of course, when it comes to play beautiful solos, maybe I will ask someone for that. Maybe we'll invite the guests. If it comes to play live shows, we will hire someone, because I won't split. So it's possible. It's possible, and everything stays in the family still. So that's why we announced about the trio, and we're sure that we can make it. Even I know that for many people, lots of things will change and it will be totally different, but it will also give us a chance to become a different band. You know, now we will have to be more open up for the new experiments, and for sure we will change our approach to lots of things. Maybe it will help our music, you know, maybe it was just the end of something, and maybe that was the mark that we should start thinking or composing from a different perspective. You know, I tried, because that was a tragic year for me. And now my father passed away, by the way, 3 months later. So, you know, it was just over and over again.
That's brutal. I'm sorry to hear that, too.
That was brutal. Besides, lots of things, you know, still going on, unfortunately, yeah. But I talk about it. But I need to look for something bright, and I need to look for the good perspective. So now I feel lots of strength, and I want to carry on. I even, you know, I'm just releasing another album with different people. Soon I will release the new Lunatic Soul. So soon also I release the new Riverside. Fuck, what the hell? You know, I can make... So I need to. I can't give up, you know. And all these things that happened will not break me at all, because life is too short to do that, you know. And I just want to be creative musician still, and be full of passion and joy. And now I feel that I'm recovering, and I'm just standing on my 2 feet again. So when I felt that, you know, and I said to the guys, let's do this. So then we announced that we will become a trio. And this is not only because we did great pictures, you know, in the sea, but we feel that we can manage that.
Yes, and they were great pictures. well, that's great to hear. And I think you express it great. And I think everybody's happy that the band is moving on and you know, recognizing the legacy of the band, like you say, it's one of the great bands we have. So happy it's moving forward.
You know, I know for many people it will be hard, because they think that, you know, maybe lots of things happened, started with electric guitar, you know. But in Riverside Core, I know we lost one of the most important cores, if I can say that, you know. Piotr was important for many people, and he defined our sound in many ways. But the heart and the soul of Riverside's music, it's not only electric guitar. And I think we can still, I can still at least take care of this. I'm not talking that we will skip the electric guitar, but I mean about some sort of playing. And I think that what is the most important in Riverside's music will still be in our music in the future. So I will definitely take care of that.
You know, you guys won a Prague Award for, I think it was like Best Song or Best Anthem, as they call it, and for Toward the Blue Horizon. What was that moment like? Almost closing of a chapter, I feel like, winning an award for that at that time.
This year, everything is just like a closing of a chapter, again, the Eye of the Soundscape, this, that. Yeah. Well, that was surprising, because I was sitting there, and I was 100% sure that we will not, you know, we will not receive anything, you know. And when they just said, okay, Riverside won, I was so pissed at myself that I didn't prepare anything to say, because I really was sure nothing would happen. So I said only thank you, bye bye. This reward is dedicated to Piotr. And later it just struck me, because I realized that wow, that's the beautiful reward, and this song has another meaning now, another layer, and it's great that someone, you know, rewarded us for this exactly. Now, so that was beautiful. You know, it's Towards the Blue Horizon. It's really very, very. The song was really close to my heart. Of course, I composed that, but I wrote it for a friend, for a very close friend who died at the age of 44. He was a really close friend of mine. And he one day he played on the guitar. One day he didn't woke up, you know. And I was so struck that the life can be so gentle. But I just wrote this song for him. And Jesus, the 2 years later, you know, the same happened with Piotr, you know. He just also didn't woke up. And didn't wake up the very next day. So people started to quote this song, you know, the lyrics. Where are you now, my friend? Everyone started to read these lyrics and, wow, it's fit, Jesus. It's like the song for Piotr. And I was a little bit pissed off because I didn't want to use this in this, you know, particular thing. But later I realized that, you know, this track is really universal. If you lose someone, you can, you know, use these words and it can fit. So that happened. That song was also for Piotr. And right. When it comes to, you know, the Prague Awards and the reward is for this song, well, it was really powerful for me.
Well, cool, man. Thanks for sharing that. And good to talk to you. Let's keep in touch.
Of course. Great. Thank you. It was really nice to meet you, Roy. And we are definitely in touch.
All right, man. Take it easy. Thanks. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you to Marius for the interview. Pick up their new album, Eye of the Soundscape, on Amazon and iTunes. For upcoming news and interviews, please check theprogreport.com. Follow us on Facebook, at The Prog Report on Twitter, or download the podcast on iTunes. Thanks.